I think I switch to my PowerPoint and then I will talk a little bit about me and I start. It's okay? Yeah?
Yeah, please go ahead.
You can share. Okay. So first of all, I would like to say namaste and thank you again for your invitation and for this opportunity to be part of this Global Summit 2020 from Tatti. And thanks to Enya, we connected on LinkedIn and she reached out to me and Joshua just jumped in and said, yes, let's invite Diana. So thanks a lot again. And I think what you are doing is just amazing to support, especially young people in this sensitive time frame we are facing. And then thank you to all the students and participants who are here, who listen to me and to all other speakers. And I dearly hope that you can take something out of it, maybe a little bit from me, a little bit from someone else. I would love to be in India right now to see you. It is much nicer than to talk to my laptop, but let's do the best and be grateful that we have the technology. Okay. Just a little bit about me. I call me the superpower coach and I say the superpower is within you. I faced in many phases in my life that the mindset is so powerful and important. And you have the power about it. And me as a German, I lived the last 20 years in 4 different countries. I moved 11 times and I love to travel. I'm a marathon junkie where I learned a lot about mindset too, because it's the half of the race is about mindset. And 2 years ago, I faced the darkest time in my life so far. I really thought everything what I worked for, it was falling apart. I was draining and draining until you come to the point where you say, okay, now I need to trust the process and it's my choice what I'm doing now. And I jumped in the cold water and I changed my life. And today I can proudly say I feel better, stronger and healthier than ever before. And believe me, I'm a few years older than you are. So when I can do it, everyone can do it too. Okay, that's just a rough agenda. So I split my topics in 3 zones, in the fear and anger zone, in the learning zone, and the growth zone. And yeah, so I would like to think back in 2020 when we started in New Year's. I don't know how it was in India, but I think it was all around the world. We were so excited about the new year, 2020. It will be our year. We were full of hope and ideas. And we said, wow, this is it's an extraordinary year. Why was it? Because of the number? I really don't know. And then suddenly, the coronavirus hit us within 1 week, 2 weeks, the whole world was in lockdown and there were so many emotions coming up, fear, anger, worry. It was just overwhelming for everyone because we never faced this before. We didn't know how it goes, how it will look like, what is coming up. And maybe the day come and we are still coming back and we think, is this really my year? You know, I'm so young and I really thought my year is totally going to be different. And it will be different because end of the year, I'm pretty sure you have your story. And what you gain this year from the year, you will never forget about it. So I would say, let's figure out how can you develop your skills? What choices do you have? And what is your takeaway for 2020 and from this lockdown? Let's say from this lockdown. I'm pretty sure it teaches us something. So when we see in the dark blues, so we are here in the anger zone. So that's where we had this panic bias in the beginning. We were totally irritated. We felt like a victim. And maybe we even blame some people, why they didn't do this, why they didn't act like that. So, and for me, it's important that you come out of this zone. You come to a learning zone where we help each other, where we say, okay, that's the situation. What can I do out of it, you know? And then in the growth zone where you say, okay, I'm here in the now and I do the most possible thing. And at the end, I really want that you are even here in the white zone. And you will, I'm pretty sure about it. So I cannot ask you personally, just have a second. And I wanted to ask you, how are you today? After these 3-4 months, sensitive, heavy time, how do you feel right now? And it's okay when you say, oh, Diana, I'm really still, I have no idea where I am right now. I feel not good. I don't have the energy. I don't have hope. Or maybe you say, oh no, actually I found my way. Whatever it is, there's no right and wrong. And it's not our point to judge you or to say, come on, you can do this. No, we need to accept where we are and where our friends are, where our colleagues are, where our family members are. We each face a time frame like this in a totally different way. So we have to accept. And it's really important to know that the negative thoughts, when they first appear, they are really the weakest. So we have a choice every day that we look in the news, in internet, TV, whatever you use. If we want, we can soak in each day with negative thoughts or with negative messages. But we can also say, okay, now it's enough when I watch it 5 or 10 minutes a day and I concentrate on totally something different. And when something comes negative and say, okay, this is not what I want in my mind, because we are full of thoughts, thousands of thoughts every day. And now we have to control, and you can control, if it's a negative, if it's demanding negatively, or if you say no, we switch to positive thinking. So, and there are different explanations about fear, but we can forget everything and run. Right now we cannot run because we are on the lockdown, but we are locked in a room, so we are like in a prison. Or we say, okay, now I face this bull, and I have strengths in everything. Me, there's so much more, and I do the best out of it. And like this girl, she's pretty cool. She says, look in my eyes, I can do this. So, and it's really your choice. Every day, whatever we do, it's our choice, how we act and how we react. And I'm a person, I really like quotes, and from Eckhart Tolle, I think it's so beautiful described when he said, accept, then act. Whatever the present moment contains, accept it is, if you had chosen it. Always work with it, not against it. Make it your friend and ally, not your enemy. This will miraculously transform your whole life. This is for me so powerful, this message, because like when we think about this lockdown, it's not only in India, it's not only in your city, it's in the whole world. It's a bit different in each country, but more or less, we face the whole situation, which is kind of incredible, even it's not nice. So, but now it's the thing is, do we blame anyone? Do we stuck with the situation? Or we say, okay, I mean, it came, we don't know why and how, but we accept this. So, and now, how can I move forward? How can I change something? How can I think in a different way? Yeah. So, and it means it's a choice. Do we go right for fear, or do we say, okay, courage. I have the courage and I try something. Maybe you figure out it was the ideal way to go, or maybe you say, okay, maybe it was not like I thought, but I have still the chance to go another courage way, another way. And when you stay in the fear zone, you stuck, so you're like frozen. And it has been never perfect, because who defines perfection? I think no one can do it, even if you're a being a perfectionist, sorry. Even then you say, no, I can do it even better. You know, there's never the right moment. The important point is that you really move forward step by step. Little step, it doesn't matter how big the step is, but do it, make a choice. So let's be curious like this fish. He says, okay, I don't want to be all with them. I want to see how it is in the next water bowl. You know, like, is this better? Is this the weather, the water better? The temperature, do I have more room? What are my options there? Let's be curious. So I want that you think more about yourself, about self-care, about self-love, that you learn to love yourself, to look in the mirror and to say, I love you. Yes, I do. You are the most important person in your life. And please care about yourself. First, love yourself. I cannot go into deeper into it. You can reach out to me, but then it's think about you, our plant. How can you refill your cup? How can you get energy? How can you have your fun? How can you enjoy your life? You have only one life, yeah? There are so many ways, like how, you know, like that you exercise with whom you are together and how you think about life. And I think you are better in India than we are in Europe, but he's a wise man. And he said, oh, he knows how powerful meditation is. It can really take away your anger, anxiety, and depression, insecurity. To find, it can be meditation, it can be something else. Maybe it's music, maybe it's reading a book, there's sport. Just to find a balance in your life to get away from all these negative thoughts. I think for me, the most powerful is also to be grateful. We can start a new day and welcome a new day, say, thank you, there's a new day, there's a new chance for me. I'm alive, I'm healthy. Yes, and I have actually a bed where I could sleep in, you know, and I can make me a tea or coffee. I can taste the tea and the coffee. I can make it with love. I can, whatever I eat, maybe you have a ventilator for the heat that is cooler in your room. Maybe you have friends. I don't know. Sorry. Do you still see my PowerPoint? Oh, yeah, no. Sorry. I had a cut in the screen. So be grateful and make it more in detail. Don't say, okay, that's a big thing. Go really in detail, and it can be really interesting and fun, and you will appreciate more and more. And even when you go to bed, think the last thing, it's not your mobile, put it away, think at least about 10 things what happened today, and be grateful, and you will sleep in a much, much better way. And maybe you can make a screenshot from this. The Admiral McRaven, he's amazing. This is a power message, how you can start your day in making your bed, the impact of making your bed, and probably you already do it. That's a small act in the morning, but that's how you get up in the morning, how you welcome your day and how you start. And so I really recommend to watch this on YouTube. So the next thing is choose wisely with whom you are connected. There are people, you have the same interests. You just connect, you can talk, you trust each other, you can laugh together. You can have serious talks, you can study. But there are also people who really drain you all the time, who talk negatively, or they're always blaming or whatever it is. But I can say from my life, it's not easy at all. But go through the people who really lift you up, who you're really looking forward to meet, and keep those. But those who are really draining you, have the courage and to say, okay, we met for a certain time frame, but now it's time to let go. Delete friends on Facebook. You are not, you know, they are not really friends. Whatever, it can be painful, but at the end, it's freeing. It's really freeing, and you want to be surrounded who have the same interests when you study, when you do sport, when you do whatever it is. But choose your friends or the connections in a really wise way, and it changes your life too. Another thing where you can think about or learn again from yourself, we are often so busy with our life, whatever we do, and or we're busy looking at others. Take from time to time the time and think about your own skills and values. And I think 2020 is a perfect year for it, to think about yourself. Are you really studying? Are you really working what you like? Is there really my passion? Is there the energy? What really drives me in the morning to get up? Where do I work and it feels not like work? And think about it, write it down, and maybe you figure out, or maybe there's something and said, okay, now is the time I can learn a new language, or I can learn an instrument, or whatever it is. That's really an amazing mind opener. And if you have a hard time to find out where your skills and values are, that's really a fun game. And I just posted it last week on LinkedIn, and the reaction were incredible. And I was asked this for 2 years ago when I applied for a job. With which three hashtags would your friends describe you? Don't explain anything, just shoot this question, send it out to your family, your colleague, to your professors, teachers, yeah. Just say, give me three words and you will be amazed. Believe me, your list will be long, and you will be amazed how your friends, how your teachers, how your family sees you. And you learn so much about yourself. And yeah, just enjoy. It's really worthwhile doing it. Yeah, and coming back to the thoughts that I said when I started in the beginning, please be careful about your thoughts. We are fulfilled with thoughts in our daily, and we are so used to it. But you have really the power of your thoughts. And if you want to change something about affirmations, when you start with I am, and maybe you are weak right now and you think, is this really me? I want to be different. Tell yourself, even you don't believe it right now, say, I am enough. I am strong enough. I am powerful. I am strong. There are so many you can look up in the internet and choose what talks to you, what you would love to say about yourself. Write it on the mirror that you see it every day. Write a small note on your laptop or on your phone as a screen stop. Or in your wallet, that you see it over and over. Say it aloud, if you believe it or not, but as many times you say it more aloud, you trigger your mind, and the moment comes and you really believe it and you live it. There are just a few examples how you can look at it when you say, oh no, I can't face this, and I don't know how I end 2020.
Diana, sorry to interrupt. Diana, 1 minute, please. Diana, in case if you're sharing a PPT, we are not able to see that. I just want to inform you.
Okay, wait.
In case if you're sharing a PPT, we are not able to see it. That's why I just want to intimate you.
I just try it again now.
Yes, please try it again. No, we are not able to see it.
Okay. So did you see it the whole time or?
No, we were just figuring out, maybe you're just talking, and suddenly we came to a concept that you were talking from a PPT.
Oh no, I had a slideshow. So that's a pity. So when I say share screen, then I do all participants, or? Only me?
All participants.
Yes, that's what I had, yeah. Oh no. And now you cannot see it?
No, we don't.
Oh.
Do you mind proceeding with the talk, or you would need the presentation? It's up to you.
I mean, it's a pity for you because there are people.
We will post it to the participants, and you can continue your motivational talk. Is that okay for you?
Yeah, sure. And I'm really sorry about this. You should.
Because we are getting adapted to technical glitches too.
Yeah. Okay. It's really a shame. Okay.
Not at all.
Okay. So just go back to the, okay, now I have to explain what I see. So I have four boxes now. So the box one is the non-to-slide energy, where you say everything is I can't. No, I can't. And then the next level would be I need to. So you have limited energy. And with the moderate energy, you tell yourself, oh, I have to clean my apartment, or I have to study, and I have to look at this. But then you have the high energy where you say, oh, I choose, and I want to, I can, and I will. Yeah. So when you start a sentence with I will clean my apartment, my flat, because then it looks much better and it's fresh air and whatever. And I choose to study because I want to learn something new. So that's two different words with an enormous change in your thinking. So now I see a picture where there's a fishbowl and the goldfish jumps out of the fishbowl in the ocean. So, and it says, take risks. If you win, you will be happy. If you lose, you will be wise. So this fish now is jumping in the ocean. This little fish has no idea what awaits in the ocean. There's maybe a shark, maybe another scary thing. He doesn't know. He is so excited. He wants to jump in and figure out what is out in the world. And that's the beauty, especially when you're young. You should try different things. You should be excited what is out there in the world. And there are so many options. And my question for you is, what do you want? What do you want to make out of your life? What do you want to tell yourself in 10, 20, 30 years? Yeah, it's your choice. And then the next one is now it's, you don't have to have it all figured out to move forward. The important thing is that you just take the next step in your life. Don't stand, move, try. Small step, big step, doesn't matter. So, and you have always you can change the direction. This is very important. That doesn't mean when you decide today, I go this way. Maybe next week, next year, say, okay, no, there are much better options. I go left, yeah? And then try to think in a different way. Turn it around. Think out of the box. Be curious, like a small child who does a curtain. Take the curtain away and say, what is behind the curtain? What is out of this box? Where's the life? Where are other options? With whom can I connect? What can I learn? What can I do differently? It really opens your mind. And now I have just coming back, like accept that the feelings and emotions are always coming, and especially stress feelings. They can be really draining, and they are also important that we have them because those are protecting us for a certain time frame. It's only the question for how long do you want to stay in the stress level. And the way how you change thinking, it will change your life. And only you have the power over your own thoughts. No one else. No one else. The others, they can feed you with things, but what you think and what you tell yourself, that's in your own hands. Please remember this. So, and now I ask you to be a change maker. So don't wait for opportunities. Create them. Be creative. Be, if it never happened before, do it. Try it. Whatever comes up, we often tell ourselves, oh, I'm not creative. This is not true. We are creative. There are others who are maybe much more creative. We are all creative. Just think about your skills, about your values you have, and use those. You are born with skills and values. You are unique. You are like a diamond, and a diamond needs edges, you know? So we have those painful times make us a new edge, but then it makes you more unique and more value. And you can throw a diamond on the floor, it will not break. And you are not breaking. You may be weak once in a while, but at the end, no, you are so special like everyone else. So, and now I have a picture in front of me. There's a little plant coming out of concrete on the street, and it says something will grow from all you are going through, and it will be you. So I want you that you believe in yourself. And when you believe in yourself, you will be unstoppable. Yeah. And when you cannot write it on your mirror, is that I believe in myself. Yes, I am. I am, I don't know your name. And repeat this and you can do it. So, and Robert Too said once in a wonderful quote, the struggle you are in today is developing the strengths you need for tomorrow. Cut the word from impossible to possible. I'm so convinced whatever you learn out of this sensitive time frame, you take it for your whole life. You will always remember this time frame and make something amazing out of it. And whatever you learned here and not stuck in your box, that's your takeaway. So, and then be patient and think not only for this moment, for this month, for this week, for this year, think in long term. Whatever you invest, whatever you do, it's long term. So when you, sometimes we tend to give up because we don't have the patience. We said, oh no, but I want to have the fruits. So when you think about a fruit tree and under the soil, there are the strong roots. As stronger the roots are, that's your base. So make sure whatever you learn and the skills you are adapting, that they are strong, that they are really, really strong, because then a storm can come and it will not hit the tree. The tree will remain. It stands straight, chest up, heads up, and any storm can nothing do with the tree. And the day comes and the fruits are there. Maybe they are coming next month, maybe next year, maybe only in 10 years. It doesn't matter. Think about this fruit tree and the strong roots. It's a pity you don't see the picture now. It's a fun picture. So most or all of it, I really ask you to have fun. Have fun now. Take time off from your laptop. Take time off from studying. Surround with your friends. Have a good laugh. Do fun things. Dance together. Crazy things, silly things. It's so important. And that's something I really had to learn too the last 2 years. Yes, I had always fun, but especially the last 2 years, having fun is the main key in your life. And don't be too serious. I know you're a serious learner and worker, but enjoy life too, okay? So, and now I have an eagle in front of me. An eagle is able to fly really, really high. And that's the thing again, when you think in long term, look at this big picture, not on a small picture right now. Fly high, have this bird view about your life, about the situation, and think further in the horizon. And when you think about your future, visualize your future, paint this in small details, what you want, and dream big. So when you have a dream, make it 10 times bigger. Go in detail, make it colorful. And if you can write it down, or you draw it, or you find pictures like a mind map from magazine, adjust it, make it nice, and put it at a wall, put it in your closet where you can see it, but remind yourself about your big picture. So now I have another 2020 sign where the people put it up, and I dearly hope end of the year you say, okay, that was the strangest year ever and I don't want to have it anymore, but I come out stronger. When I look back in the beginning of the year, even I had this big hope and thought that's an amazing year. What I learned this year, it's so, so much. And it's think always back, how were you in January, how you are today? I'm pretty sure you have changed. And now think another 6 months, and 6 months you have so many choices. Make the best out of it, and what will be your takeaway for 2020? So my slideshow comes to an end. I would like to say thank you first, and I thank you a virtual hug. I'm a hug person. And feel free to connect with me. You're more than welcome to connect with me through LinkedIn if you have an account, since you cannot see my slide. Maybe Joshua can share it with you. And
yeah,
just
we'll do message. That.
That's fine. Yeah, and I'm so sorry that you cannot see my slideshow.
It was so really great. It was so great. We even got some of the participants saying that you were doing great even without the PPT.
Oh, yes. Okay. Thank you. Yeah.
Thank you very much, Diana, for that very inspirational speech. I think it was a need of the hour. Can we go for a quick question, Diana? Is that fine with you?
Yes, sure. Of course. As long as I can
Yeah. From one of the participants, we have a question. Could you please tell us how to handle depression?
How to handle the?
Depression.
The pressure?
Depression.
Depression, yes. I mean, that's really important with depression. It's really not easy to be in this stage, yeah, and to get out of it. But what's really helpful is that you make a journal, buy a beautiful book. You can put a paper too, but I really recommend a journal book which you love, which talks to you. Write down every single day in the morning, write down how grateful you are and write it with your hands. It makes a huge difference. Yeah, be more grateful, see more the beauty in your life. See, like, as I said, about the skills and values you have. There's so much beauty in your life, and see more. It's the way of thinking. You have to shift your mindset. And you have the power of your mind. And when you pay attention, then normally in depression, you have really negative thoughts. You're fulfilled all day long. Write it down, something, look for positive affirmations. Say them aloud. If you believe, probably you don't believe it, but say it aloud over and over and over. And the day comes and it shifts you.